Hi there. This is a quick tutorial about the skills view in Seesaw. For those of you whose schools have purchased the Seesaw for Schools, you'll have access to skills, which will let you track your students' posts by proficiency scale. If you're not sure if your school has Seesaw for Schools, I'm going to click over here just so you can see the list really quickly. Over here on the side, it's showing all of the different schools that have actually purchased. I'm going to scroll down so you can see the rest. So these are all of the schools who purchased Seesaw for Schools for next year. Some of them only purchased it for certain grade levels. So if you're not certain or if you're not seeing these features, you might just want to check in with your principal. So one of the coolest things about Seesaw for Schools is the skills view. It's going to let you tag all of your student posts. So all of the work that they're putting in here, you're going to be able to tag it with the proficiency scale and score it. And what's really nice about Seesaw for Schools is that I'm able to upload the proficiency scales for you. That's not something you have to do on your own. But this part I think is a little bit weird. So all of the skills have been added, but if you click over here, it doesn't look like there's anything there. It says no skills set up. It looks like you have to manually add skills. It's just because none of them have been tagged yet. So I'm going to go back to my journal and I'm going to pretend that this post right here is something that I would want to tag so that I could document this for student learning. So underneath the post, I'm going to click on the graduation hat. And you'll see in here, this is a kindergarten classroom. All of the math and ELA proficiency scales are already added in here. So this teacher would just need to find that skill or that scale and tag it. You can see I could scroll. I could also search. So if I'm looking for something in particular, I could start typing in either the name of the proficiency scale or the related standard is also tagged so that you could look that way. So let's say I'm going to call this one Analyzing Narratives. I'm going to go ahead and click that and tag this with the Analyzing Narratives. Now when I click over here, you'll see that that's actually been added to my skills view because now I have posted that to a journal post. So now it shows up. All of these say zero. It's showing that there's no pieces of work associated with any of these students. Here, this student has that one piece tagged. I love that I can just click on it and see this piece. If I want to score it, when I click on here, I could give it a one, two, three, or four, depending on how this student did. And now when I look at my skills view, hold on one second. Sorry. So now you can see that it color-coded it because I gave it that score. So what you're going to find here is as you tag skills, it's going to show those different proficiency scales across the top here. As you score them, you're going to see that it's color-coded, and these numbers here will change. That's going to be how many pieces of work were tagged with that particular skill. If you don't have Seesaw for Schools, there is something called Seesaw Plus that would give you access to these skills as well. If you want to try that, send me an email and I can give you a code to try that for like 30 days just to try this out.